Hey folks, good morning. I wanted to see if I can post some videos on how to use Pixinsight. But before I do that, I wanted to explain what Pixinsight is all about. Well, Pixinsight is a great astrophotography processing tool. As you can see, the pictures, very nice looking ones, those are all made by Pixinsight. You can get a free copy of the Pixinsight by going into their software, register yourself. You get a 30-day free trial. 30-day free trial is not enough, but I think that will get you started. You can also go to Pixinsight/forums website. You have to register for this website, but once you got approved to use this website, there is a wealth of information. There are several folks that are contributing, and there are so many cool features of Pixinsight they are discussing. There are pros out here. This is the good place to start. If you are interested in downloading or if you are interested in buying the software, I would recommend to use a good computer or a laptop that has a minimum of 8 GB memory or 16 GB. I found that useful. And also an external hard drive for the memory, like storing the images and all, would be very helpful. I think Pixinsight works both on Windows and Mac as well. I think when you open the Pixinsight software, it could be overwhelming. This is one of the reasons why I thought of putting some learning videos on how to use Pixinsight. So Juan is the principal developer of Pixinsight. Based on his latest interview, he and his wife started this company. They had a Pixinsight Lite, and it seems like that software was very successful. And then they moved on to more of a commercial version. So if you see in the Pixinsight, most of the Pixinsight work either processes or scripts. So when you import your astrophotography pictures from your CMOS camera or CCD camera or DSLR camera, you run all these various processes and scripts using Pixinsight. This tool is very good for developing the deep space astrophotography pictures. You can also use that for enhancing the planetary pictures, but not necessarily the stacking. So you can use like Registacks and all still from a stacking perspective of planetary and bring those pictures here and make them enhanced. But I believe the Deep Sky Stacker versus Pixinsight, most of the stacking work that it does, the Pixinsight is doing that using either batch pre-processing or several other processes that are out here on the channel management and channel integration side. I think they are taking care of them. Similar to what we do in Adobe Photoshop, I think the curves transformation, the color management, the dynamic crop, the morphological transformation, all these processes that we have in Pixinsight, similar to what we had in Photoshop, I think are pretty complementary. You can still use Photoshop for enhancing the picture, making it much better. This concludes the overview of what Pixinsight is. I wanted to put out one tutorial for every one of these processes. I wanted to create them as a workflow so that it's easy for me to understand or for you to understand. And you can actually create a workflow based on that. I have a website, whatsappastro.com. So what I'm planning to do is, I wanted to create Pixinsight tutorials along with the screen captures and all here. So when you go to these tutorials, you should be able to access the pictures and the files that I'm using for downloading and all. I hope this Pixinsight videos will help you learn Pixinsight quickly and create great pictures. Please do share your comments. Thanks for watching.